Today we are going to discuss problem number 2. It asks you to prepare Pawan's account from the following. Now the transactions are given for the period of from March 1st to March 28th. On March 1st, goods purchased from Pawan. So you are supposed to prepare Pawan's account. So you are going to prepare only one account, that is Pawan's account. So in order to prepare Pawan's account, you require Pawan's account, which is you need the columns as what you have learned in the ledger intro. So this is basically your ledger format. Next, so we have the debit side, we have the credit side, then date, particulars, your journal folio, amount, then again date, particulars, then you have journal folio and rupees. Now, in the problem, you are instructed to prepare Pawan's account. So therefore, in the middle of the format, on the top, you will write Pawan's account. Now, in order to prepare Pawan's account, we have to go back to our basics. We need to know our journal entries properly, and there are two ways. Either you want to, if you are a beginner, as a beginner, you write your journal entry roughly and then do the posting, or if you feel you're confident enough, then directly analyze and record journal entry in your mind and then post it into Pawan's account. So since you are beginners, you can write your journal entries roughly and then do the posting. So the first transaction is on March 1st. Goods purchased from Pawan. So we are running a business and we are buying the goods from Pawan. So our entry, if you remember roughly, it could be purchases account debit to Pawan's account. Purchases account debit to Pawan's account, applying the rule of what you learned earlier. So the amount being 38,000. Now this, you do it roughly, and let us now post this journal entry to Pawan's account, which you are preparing here. So the transaction is on 1st March. Now in the journal entry, Pawan's account is credited with 38,000. So in our ledger, this is Pawan's account, and we have to go to the credit side and write the date 1st March. Now, Pawan is credited with 38,000. So go to the amount column and write 38,000. Now, why we have to credit Pawan's account? Because we purchased goods from Pawan. So the reason is purchases. So as we discussed on credit side, buy is constant. After writing buy, state the reason. It is because of purchases we are crediting Pawan's account. So this is the first posting of the transaction. Now next transaction states that cash paid to Pawan 5,000. Cash paid to Pawan 5,000 is on 6th. So cash paid to Pawan, the journal entry would be cash account debit, cash paid to Pawan would be Pawan account, debit to cash, 5K, that is 5,000. Now, if you see this journal entry for the transaction of 6th, Pawan's account is debited. So let us post it into Pawan's account. Since Pawan's account is debited in the journal entry, go to the debit side of Pawan's account in the ledger and give the date first, 6th March. So in the journal entry, you have debited Pawan's account with 5,000. So put this 5,000 in the amount column. Now, look in the journal entry for the reason for debiting Pawan's account. It is because of cash. Now, so on debit side, the constant is 2. And the reason for debiting Pawan's account is you paid cash to him. So you have written cash. Now, let us take the transaction on 10th, which is goods returned to Pawan. So you have purchased goods from Pawan, you have on credit. So we already discussed goods purchased on credit can also be returned. So the transaction of 10th, goods returned to Pawan, means the journal entry would be Pawan's account debit to which goods we are returning? Purchased goods. So it would be purchases returns account. What's the amount? It is 1500. 1500. Now, if you see this journal entry, Pawan's account is debited. So let us again go to the debit side of Pawan's account in the ledger, and the date is 10th March. So 2 is the constant, and Pawan's account debit, we have debited with 1500, so write that 1500 in the amount column. The reason for debiting Pawan's account is purchase returns. So write purchase returns in the particulars column. Okay. Now, the next transaction is on 14th. On 14th, it is paid to Pawan by check rupees 6,800. So Pawan's account in the journal will be debited because he is the receiver. So it is Pawan's account debit. Since we are issuing a check, it would be Pawan's account debit to bank account. The amount being 6,800. 6,800. So if you have to post this, again Pawan's account is debited in the journal. So therefore, we should go to the debit side of Pawan's account in the ledger, give the date 14th in the date column, then constant 2, and Pawan's account debit is 6,800. In the amount column, write 6,800. The reason we are debiting Pawan's account is because we gave him a check, which is nothing but we have represented with the bank in the journal entry. Now, the next transaction is on 20th. Which states that discount allowed by Pawan, which states that it is discount allowed by Pawan. So who is Pawan? He is outsider from whom we have purchased the goods. So he is allowing discount, means we are gaining the discount. So it is a gain for us. So the entry would be journal entry, Pawan's account debit to discount received account. The amount being 5,000. So as per this journal entry, you have again debited Pawan's account. So go to the debit side of Pawan's account in your ledger. That is on 20th. On the debit side, give the date. You have debited Pawan's account with 5,000. So in amount column, write 5,000. Next, you know 2 is a constant in the particulars column on the debit side. And the reason for debiting Pawan is he gave you discount. So write 2 discount received. Now, the next transaction is goods purchased from Pavan for cash. On 26th, you have goods purchased from Pavan for cash. If you carefully observe, it is a cash transaction. So when it is a cash transaction, first let us journalize this roughly. So you are buying goods, so therefore we would be debiting purchases account. So purchases account debit. Since you are paying cash, cash is going out, we are crediting it. So as a result, your journal entry is becoming purchases to cash. And here we are preparing Pavan's account. This transaction is no way affecting Pavan. Therefore, we don't post this transaction to Pavan's account. So the transaction of 20th will not affect Pavan's account. Therefore, you will not post it. The last transaction is on 28th. It is furniture purchased from Pavan. So furniture purchased from Pavan,